Hello, Ace. This is Reto2K2, and today you'll learn all about null in C#. We'll take a look at what a reference type is and find out what references are exactly. Then I'll explain what the null literal is and discuss the null reference. After that, we'll see what a null-coalescing operator is. And finally, we'll touch upon nullable types. If this is the first C# video of mine you're seeing, I'd strongly advise watching the series from the start. Card should be on your screen now. And if you haven't already, I'd advise you to download the channel files that accompany this video. The card should be on your screen once again. So let's get started. To make sense of what a null reference is, we must first look at what a reference is. And to do that, we must look at reference types. What are reference types? Well, according to the Microsoft docs, there are two kinds of types in C#, reference types and value types. Variables of reference type store reference to their data, objects, while variables of value types directly contain their data. With reference types, two variables can reference the same object. Therefore, operations on one variable can affect the object referenced by the other variable. With value types, each variable has its own copy of the data, and it is not possible for operations on one variable to affect the other. Let's discuss this further, Ace. Open up Unity and create a basic C# script. As always, make sure you give your script a different name than any other class in your project. Here I'm creating a super basic class, Ace, so feel free to call it whatever you like. I'm also going to declare a basic int field called myInt. We've already seen that we can create a new object and assign it to the variable myClass, but it's important to note that we aren't actually assigning that object to the variable. We are assigning a reference to that object to the myClass variable. So if we create another variable and assign myClass to it, we are actually assigning the same reference to the instance of the basic class 15 object. If I change the value of myInt to 10 and log out both variables myInt field, save the script, head back into Unity, drag our tutorial 15 onto any game object in the scene, and run the game, you'll see that both myClass and myClass2's myInt variable has value 10. Both myClass and myClass2 reference the same basic class 15 instance, and so any change made to that instance will be seen across all the variables that reference that object. This is an extremely important concept to understand, Ace, and that's why I'm devoting a fair bit of time to explaining it. The basic class 15 is a reference type. If we attempt the same thing with a value type, we'll see very different behavior. For this, I'm going to use the Vector3 struct, Ace. A struct is a value type, and I'll be devoting a full video to it soon. Unfortunately, I need to use them to demonstrate this point, and it'll be easier to understand this way round as opposed to the other way. I know, Ace, it's not ideal, but we shall prevail. Here, I'm creating a new Vector3 called myVector3. Next, I'm assigning another variable called myNewVector3 to the myVector3's value. It looks like we've done the exact same thing as above, but since Vector3 is a struct and is therefore a value type, it's copied on assignment and a new instance is created. So now if I change the x field of myNewVector3 to 20 and log out the x field of both of the variables, what should we expect to see? Save, head back into Unity and rerun the game, and you'll see that 1 is logged and so is 20. Completely different to the reference type behavior we've seen before. Now that that's out of the way, we can finally look at null. What is null? Well, according to the Microsoft docs, the null keyword is a literal that represents a null reference, one that does not refer to any object. Null is the default value of reference type variables. Ordinary value types cannot be null. Back in the code, I'm going to declare a variable with the basic class 15 type. Instead of creating a new instance of our object using the new keyword, we are simply going to attempt to log out the object's myInt field. But as you can see, yes, we are hit with the error local variable obj might not be initialized before accessing. Okay, let's make our obj a field in the tutorial 15 class and change its name so that we can identify it as a private field. I'm also going to comment out our previous code here, Ace, just so that we don't clutter the console. Here we don't get the same error, but the same situation still exists. We haven't initialized the obj field before accessing it. Save the script, head back into Unity, and rerun the game. And oh no, we're hit with a big ugly error in the console. This is the null reference exception, and you will no doubt see this error constantly throughout your programming life. Yes. Let's go through this slowly. The initial value of any reference type, that's any type that isn't a value type base, will be null. So this is the same as this. The problem here is that our obj2 variable hasn't been assigned an object reference, but we are attempting to use it assuming that it has. You can check if a variable is null by using an if statement, like so. Here I'm checking to see if object2 equals null, and if it does, I want to assign it a new basic class 15 object reference. Once it has a reference to an object's instance, we can use the variable like normal. You can use this little trick to initialize properties too, yes. This is called lazy initialization, but it's a little beyond what we're talking about now. We can simplify this statement too, yes, by converting it to a null-coalescing expression. What is null-coalescing? Well, according to the Microsoft docs, the ?? Operator is called the null-coalescing operator. It returns the left-hand operand if the operand is not null, otherwise it returns the right-hand operand. So if I click the if text, press Alt and Enter, and then press Enter, the if statement will change to a null-coalescing expression. Here, the object reference in the obj field will be returned if it is not null. If it is null, the obj field is assigned a new basic class 15 instance, and that instance is returned. Very similar to the ternary operator that we looked at in the conditional operators video, yes. The card is on your screen now in case you missed that. Okay, let's have a look at nullable types. According to the Microsoft docs, nullable types are instances of the system nullable T struct. A nullable type can represent the correct range of values for its underlying value type, plus an additional null value. For example, a nullable int32, pronounced nullable of int32, can be assigned any value from -2,147,483,648 to 2,147,483,647, or it can be assigned the null value. A nullable of bool can be assigned the values true, false, or null. They are defined by putting a ?? After the variable's value type, like so. Int ? Is shorthand for the type nullable of int, which uses generics. We'll get onto the topic of generics at some point in the series, yes. You cannot convert a reference type to a nullable object, and attempting to do so will give you the error cannot convert source type basic class 15 to target type system.nullable of basic class 15. Nullable types are very interesting, yes. The main philosophy behind them is to allow for any undefined value. So with our myInt variable, we can assign it any int value we like, but we can also assign it the null type. Strangely enough, accessing a property on the object that has a null value doesn't throw a null reference exception as you would probably expect, yes. This is because nullable is a struct type, but again, we'll talk about those in a future video. You can even do arithmetic with your nullable values, yes. Adding 10 to our value of 10 gives us the predictable value of 20, but adding 10 to our null value will give us null. You can't assign the int nullable value to a standard int variable either, yes. To do that, you'd have to access the nullable's value property, but be warned, yes, accessing the value property of a nullable that is null will throw the invalid operation exception. Nullable object must have a value. This can be avoided by checking the nullable's have value property or comparing it to the null literal directly. And hey, if it is null, we can even use the lazy initialization tactic to assign it a valid value. This has been a fairly basic look at the null literal in C#. Believe me, yes, it's not the last we'll hear from it either, and it will forever plague our Unity C# development. I feel like Q whenever he introduced Captain Picard to the Borg. I trust that you're a Star Trek fan, yes. And that's it. Rate, comment, and subscribe, yes. Prepare to be assimilated. You can email me at retrotk2@gmail.com with your null exceptions. Thank you for watching this, and I'll see you in the next video.